disappointed, you can be sad, you can be disappointed, whatever it might be. And then you're like, all right, back to the grind. I'm gonna wake up in the morning, I'm gonna do my workout, and then I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna practice, and whatever it might be. Everybody, it's Chelsea Melcher. So nice to be back with you today. If this is your first time watching, I am a classically trained singer and I've also opened up a music school, and now I just love inspiring other people and giving a lot of information and help and support to other music teachers and students of all ages. Today I'm going to talk to you about if you're considering, or if you have a student that's considering going into performing, and I'm talking about either whether it be vocal performance or a musical theater, those types of things, and just a little bit, a couple tidbits of information about what to prepare yourself for a little bit. Some things I wish that someone would have talked to me about before I really went into it hardcore. So the first thing is, see how much dabbling you can do now. It's easy to get caught up in almost like a small town syndrome where you can be a big fish in a little pond. And in that, it can maybe give you a lot more confidence, but then it can be a big and possibly rough transition when you go into college, or more so post-grad. And so if you can start dabbling into things now, you will be much better off. Meaning, start doing some research, start watching masterclasses, start learning as many pieces as you possibly can to really beef up your repertoire. And then in that, it's going to really show you, are you fascinated by all this? Are you really attracted to the hustle and the grind of this? And if so, that's probably a really good indication of like, oh, this is probably an appropriate path for you. Or are you someone where you're super overwhelmed and you're like, oh my gosh, there's just so much to do. And not that you wouldn't be overwhelmed at all, but the fact of going through that and doing some research and starting to dabble into things and learn things, and you're like, oh, this is too much work, then it might be a good indication of something to just keep in mind as you make your decision, because that type of hustle and grind and hard work is really a part of it. And so it's got to be something that you're willing to be a part of in your life. Another thing to think about is that it's never too late. A lot of times people are like, oh, well, I didn't do all of these. I mean, there's some people that I know that did all these acting classes and all these summer programs before they were even 12 years old. And now they're doing this and they're doing this in New York. And like, well, what am I? I am a senior in high school, or a junior in high school, or I am 32 years old, or whatever it may be, wherever you're at in your journey. It's never too late. You can change careers. You can decide to do things at any point. And there's not a rule book on that. So also keep that in mind. Don't feel like because you haven't started something, or you didn't do this, or you didn't do all these summer camps or something like that, that for some reason you wouldn't be able to make it or have a career. And so that's not true. Keep that in mind. Another thing is, anytime that you do something for an extended period of time and you don't give yourself time to really stress relieve and find yourself and recenter yourself and have a good outlet or good mentorship or a good support system, you will get burnt out. So why am I talking about this? Is because a lot of times when you're growing up, music and performing is your outlet for stress and for other things. It's a therapy in your life. And so it has a different type of energy in your life. And then all of a sudden, if and when you decide to become a performer or really go into it hardcore in college, all of a sudden there's a different pressure. There's a different place that it has in your life. And that could be to pay your bills. Because if you're going the performing route and you're like, that's what I'm gonna do, and maybe you'll have a side job of some sort to really help support yourself. But if there's this pressure of like, oh my gosh, this contract that I'm in is for 2 weeks, and then what next? What after that? Or this contract, I mean, we have 16 shows, and then but then that's 2 months, and then what? And so there's this feeling of pressure, almost, with some people at least, and that, oh my gosh, how do I support myself? How do I keep paying for this and this and this if my income comes from performing? And so realize that sometimes the very thing that was your stress relief at one point, if all of a sudden you put this pressure on it, like this is how I'm gonna make my living, that kind of pressure can make the stress a whole lot different, and it could possibly cause you to be burnt out. I mean, there's a whole lot of pressure and negativity and rejection anyway in a career like that. And so just be careful that you give yourself time and you don't put a lot of pressure on yourself. You find other ways to work around that, but you also give yourself time to have some moments where you can get away from it, or you can have a vacation from it in whatever way that is for you. Because, and this is true with any career, anytime that you do something for a long period of time and you just grind and hustle and grind and hustle, you can get burnt out. I mean, I've gotten burnt out from performing. I've gotten burnt out from teaching. I've gotten burnt out from having a music school. I've gotten burnt out from a lot of things. And so it's just remembering what's most important and being able to find yourself and find your happiness and joy and your peace again through all of that grind and that hustle. Another thing to really start thinking about is rejection. And you may not have experienced this very much growing up, or if you're living in a small town of some sort, and it's the fact that there are so many people doing exactly what you're doing, and that's fine. But that means that you're not gonna get everything that you wanna get. And I think that transitioning into college can be a rough transition for some people if they come from a school that's smaller where they were kind of getting a lot of things. But then if they're transitioning after college into the real world and all of a sudden it's like this whole new level of stuff, it can be a big slap in the face. And so if you're somebody that if you don't get something that you want, you just kind of huddle in a corner and you just cry for weeks and you're just like, blah, 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 I'm just done, and you're so discouraged, that's something to think about. Now, disclaimer here, you can be disappointed, you can be sad, you can be upset, but there has to kind of be a limit. There has to be a limit. You can do your thing. You can eat your ice cream. You can cry in the corner. You can go throw a racquetball around or whatever it is that you do for stress. But then you kind of got to pick yourself back up and keep working. And knowing that just because you didn't get something does not necessarily mean that you're not talented. It does not necessarily mean that you couldn't do an amazing job on it. There are just so many factors to consider. And so you can take rejection with a grain of salt, and you can teach yourself, because this doesn't come naturally necessarily, but you can teach yourself to really develop a little bit of a thicker skin, more of a backbone, and be like, okay, just because they don't want me, that doesn't mean that what I have to offer is any less. That doesn't mean that I'm not technically prepared. That doesn't mean whatever, because we can go through our heads and be like, oh, maybe they didn't like this, maybe they didn't like this. And there is some of that to be done. There is some constructive criticism always, because we are always learning, always growing. However, it cannot dominate that. And you can't lose a sense of a feeling that you have value as a musician, as a performer, as a teacher, as a person, just because somebody else said, oh, no thanks, I'd like the watermelon today instead of the grapes, right? Both are grapefruits. And so there's a lot of just a matter of opinion or what they're looking for at that particular time. And so if you can take that rejection and just let it keep you motivated, you can be sad, you can be disappointed, whatever it might be. And then you're like, all right, back to the grind. I'm gonna wake up in the morning, I'm gonna do my workout, and then I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna practice, and whatever it might be. And you can pick yourself back up, then you'll probably be just fine. Not to say that rejection doesn't hurt, because it does, and it's disappointing, and it's frustrating, and it's all of the things. But you gotta be able to pick yourself back up. after that. Another thing to consider is finding your niche, meaning finding what's something that you really do well, maybe that's unique about you and the way that you express yourself in a musical way or acting or dancing, and really trying to hone in on that. Because when you think about in the broad spectrum, like everybody's pretty, everybody has a nice voice, everybody's talented, everybody can dance. And so those are all givens, first off. So just make sure that if you're not really trying to make sure that you're the best performer, the best singer, the best dancer that you could possibly be, those are kind of like even ground level before we even get to this. And then once we're at this thing, it's finding what do you do that's very, very unique. So maybe you studied ballet like crazy growing up, and so you're really interested in performing, but you're also a really great ballerina. I mean, maybe look and research, like what are some of the characters that you have to have a really strong dancer for, and then try to emulate some of those pieces in your auditions and work through that way. So it's really finding what do you do that's really strong, maybe a little bit unique, and focusing in on that. And so those are ways that will definitely help you. And so this is just the start of a conversation about things to consider when going into the musical world, the performing route, the college route. And so pass this on, share this with anyone that you feel like needs to hear this, or that there's some thing that is important for them to really take into consideration. And as always, please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this. And thank you so much for joining us. And I also wanted to invite you to come into our private Facebook group. If these videos or podcasts are helpful to you, we have a place where we go even deeper and we have conversations and we talk about things that we wanna really discuss. And then there are things that are just released only in that group. And this can be for music teachers, this can be for music performers, this can be people that are trying to find the balance of like, do I perform or do I teach? Or how do I find that? I love music, I want it to be a part of my life, or maybe I'm a music major. And so if that's you, if any of this really resonates with you, then you can request to join our group. It's called Music Major to Music Professional. And it is a special group to me. It's special people. And I'll just tell you right off the bat, if you're one of those types of people that you like to challenge people in Facebook groups or chats of some sort or that kind of thing, like do not even ask to join the group, because anything like that, any person that's gonna make comments like that, it's just, there's no time for that. This is just a safe place, okay? So it's not supposed to be one of those huge groups of like 65,000 people in it. No, this is supposed to be a very special, unique type of person. And so if this seems like it's up your alley, then you can request to join the group and we'd love to have you join us. And we will talk about all the things, and you can reach out to me personally and ask me to talk about certain things. And it's just, we have a great time. It's the place to be. So come join us, Music Major to Music Professional.